Tatsu, welcome back to another hilarious episode of Ero Manga Sensei. The story about the little sister. What was this show about? Showing off how cute Elf actually is and how much of a pervert Sagiri is. Oh boy. And that bookstore lady. So evil. She's really, really evil. She totally did what you had to do in that situation, and she did it with full power in such a glorious way that it is just awesome. And man, we continuing this episode where the last episode ended, and it's in the bookstore, and Megumin, she decided she wants to start reading these creepy otaku novels. Bookstore-chan isn't very amused about that name for the light novels, and she's discussing with Masamune how to deal with it, and she has such a cruel plan, making her addict to light novels. She took a bunch of light novels, recommended them, made Megumi buying these titles, and all of them ended in a fucking cliffhanger. This is how you deal with it. That's the way you do it. Like a big boss, like the final villain or whatever. So good. I laughed my ass off seeing how Megumin reacted to all of this, and she was like, you know, you are right, right? Talk to the authors and say they have to continue writing because I want to know what's happening next. And man, this was hilarious. This scene was so funny. And I totally get it. Reading a light novel and it's ending with a cliffhanger, or not even a cliffhanger, but in the middle of a story arc, because the story arc is longer than a single volume, and you're just like, I have to wait for the next one, please no! And you're totally depressed about it. And then there's also something I can totally relate to it. How do you deal with this void in your heart while waiting for the continuation, or even after a story has finished? Well, you will deal with it in the way that you're reading more. So yeah, I can totally relate to that discussion about what to do while waiting for the continuation of a light novel, or basically if it's not especially that the story ended, but what if the story ends and you have this hole in your chest where you're like, oh boy, what to do with my life anymore? I don't know. I guess I'll read some more, and this is just what I'm doing. So, yep, very relatable point here. And then Megumin visited Sagiri. Oh boy. Oh boy. Man, this was criminal. I wanted to call the police, but I didn't do it. But man, Sagiri, you're a young girl. And yet your face was totally like the perverted old dude. And it was glorious. It was justice. It was amazing. It was hilarious. Megumin standing there blindfolded and tied up so that she can't do anything. And Sagiri was drawing her without saying anything, and Megumin was getting more and more uneasy, and it was pointed out by Masamune that she was just showing off, and actually she's just a girl with no experience whatsoever. And then she said that she saw a dick once. Yeah. I wonder what happened there. Probably nothing special. Or she looked it up on the web. But yeah, I think that's about her experience. And then we have this very crazy shot with Megumin and then Sagiri coming closer from behind and looking from under her to the hidden secrets under the skirt. And then, all of a sudden, she pulled down the panties. This was so criminal and I was laughing my ass off. It was just too good. And then they became not really friends, but Sagiri recommended her favorite novel and lent it to her. And I wonder if she also did it with the cliffhanger. So yeah, getting her addicted to light novels, very great, and I really liked how they are doing it. On the other side, we have now a bit more of story going on for this story part, with Masamune being in trouble of not being able to publish his new book. And it said that the company tends to publish it next May, which is an entire year from now on. So he's troubled by it because he made a promise or a deal with the aunt and that he has to publish something every year or not having a gap of 1 year or longer so that they continue this way they are living. And it kind of sounds fishy and I wonder what the aunt is actually trying to do. And I wouldn't even be surprised, I will be totally honest, I wouldn't be surprised if the aunt would be maybe someone we know from Oreimo. Just the simple fact would be so funny that I would just, I don't know, run through the street naked and playing a trumpet or whatnot, I don't know. It's just so crazy and just the thought about it, if we ever get to know the aunt, that she's someone we know from Oreimo and that this would be really like, well, yeah. The apple is not falling that far away from the tree or something like this. I don't know how to translate that line to English, but yeah, it would be funny. So yeah, Masamune trying to publish his new book, and he is entering one of these, well, kind of competitions, and the winner is able to publish the book in September, later this year. And there was another girl standing in front of the publisher building, and in the end, it turned out that she is Muramasa Senju, the top-selling light novel writer, younger than Masamune, having the same writing style and stuff like this. So Masamune being troubled by it because he was called a fake Muramasa and whatever, and yeah, but we will get more of it in the next episodes. Because, and I will be honest here, I think that Muramasa is quite an entertaining character and she adds quite a lot of spice to the overall story. And I really have to continue reading the light novel. I've read 3 or 4 volumes and yeah, it's very funny and I really like how they will explain her, let's just call it, troubled relationship with Masamune. So yeah, very funny, and I'm looking forward to see the next episode, which will be next Saturday. Ah, such a good show. Seriously, one of the best anime of this season. I know it's a trashy show, but just being a trashy show doesn't mean that it is bad in that way. So yeah, Great show, great episode. I love it. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Bye bye.